Hi everyone, this is Johnnyonoes, and I'm playing Stranded Deep version 0.16, and in this Let's Play episode, we're going to do a couple things. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to gaze at all the junk that we've accumulated throughout this whole Let's Play series. All of our wall materials, a little bit of steel, pile of rocks, pile of cloth. I even brought over a couple, I think 4 barrels. I used 1 barrel as a nightstand. Here's my little nightstand. My bed. I had all my spears propped up against the wall, but we're going to be using them today, so took them. So yeah, I got all my jerry cans. Just got all the junk that we've accumulated. I moved it all from Island 10 over here home to Island 7. So it is 6:30 in the morning. It's July 6th now. We've survived for 44 days. So I basically spent about 2 weeks, moving everything over, healing up from our last adventure where we overextended quite a bit. I think we ended up with like 1 tick of health. And we got everything now in Island 7. I also spent a great deal of time doing some experiments with our McMansion. So I put down the whole foundation, which is a 9x9 platform. And I came across some discoveries, some that I'm happy about, some that I'm not. The ones that I'm happy about are that sharks, they do come back. If you hit them with spears, they will eventually come back. I ran into a shark just the other day, actually, in the game, which was porcupined with spears already. Like, so I've been throwing spears, like I'm just trying to kill the sharks before they can run away. I would suggest you don't. Really take your time, you know, aim every shot, because you'll see a shark with a bunch of spears sticking out of it, you know, weeks after you've encountered it. So that was a really, really fun experience, or one fun discovery that I found out about. The other one was the ability to move barrels from zone to zone. And while I wasn't able to do multiple per trip, I was able to do 1 with the raft that we have with the tires in the front. So I was able to bring some barrels over. You can definitely make a hobo stove and other stuff with that. So that's really nice to be able to move that. The discovery that I'm really not happy about is that there is some sort of structural integrity when it comes to building. Apparently, you can't go further than 2 squares worth of a building without ceilings collapsing on itself. So basically, my 9x9... you know, majestic McMansion is basically either going to be nullified and just reduced, and we just have a really, really nice, gigantic deck. Or what we can do is we can create supports using doorways inside the building. I'm going to be definitely showing off this limitation in my Let's Learn video about, you know, what are the limitations in building in version 0.1. The really unfortunate thing about it, my now, when you're looking at all the building materials here, unfortunately, there is no supports. So you have to build walls inside of a larger building to allow it to stay standing. And that was really depressing, because I've made gigantic buildings in the past. They weren't multi-level because multi-level buildings weren't available then. But I was able to make really gigantic buildings where I'd had like 40 sharks just lined in a row waiting to be devoured. But unfortunately, what we're looking at here is we've got to make a decision on, do we make like a smaller house with a couple rooms in it to keep it stable, or maybe just go with a 2x2 house, just like we do with the bungalow over there, which you can't see. You can only see posts right now. Let me get closer to it. So yeah, this 2x2 is the biggest room or biggest house you can make without any rooms. It is a 2x2 house. So that was a little bit sad. I also figured out how to move foundations, which was an exercise in itself. And it's one of the main reasons why this video is late today. But yeah, I was able to get all the foundations facing the same way. And I'll be discussing that in my Let's Learn video that I make for building. So that's kind of the state of affairs as it stands. We have all of the stuff. I think I left about 4 buckets worth of buckets over at Island 10. So it's still a pretty viable place to survive if need be. I brought all the food over, so all my little fish pieces that I had are pretty much eaten while I was doing the building, collecting wood and all that stuff. So I still have two pieces of shark meat available for us. So we're doing pretty good. The only problem is we're starting to run out of resources, run out of food, and we're running out of water. I mean, water shouldn't be too much of an issue because we have all these buckets. But we're at a point now where we need to secure this area so that we can survive here, you know, for as long as we wish to survive. So let's go ahead and get started with that. So the first thing we're going to build are a couple of solar stills. So let's see. Here we go. Let's build four of them. Let's be extravagant. So we're going to need 16 rocks, four tarps, and we got plenty of buckets to go around. So let's go ahead and do that. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we go. Now let's head on over. Put this away. Let's go ahead and make our solar stills. Let's put them right over here. This one. Just pick the buckets up here. Let's get some empty ones. That way we have everything in our inventory. Okay. It's number three. And number four. This is going to be pretty good. We're going to be pretty good. We're not going to run out of water ever now. So that's pretty nice. The next thing we're going to build is we're going to build a hobo stove. And I know a hobo stove just isn't necessary, but I want to make a hobo stove. Just because I need to make it. So we're going to make a campfire to start. And we'll put it, you know, we'll keep everything on the wet sand here. Good thing there's no tide systems. Because if there were, then we'd be SOL when the tide comes in. Then I think we need four rocks. Let's get two more stacks of rock. And let's go ahead and make the fire pit. There we go. And then for the hobo stove, all we need is a barrel. Let's drag this bad boy over here. This barrel has been on quite an adventure in its life. Oop. There we go. Boom. Hobo stove completed. Look at this thing. It's awesome. Oh, it's so good. All right, let's go ahead and make another campfire. Let's see what we need to make for the smoker. We just need to make another pit. Put it right here. Then there's the campfire pit. And then for the smoker, we're going to need some sticks and a tarp. We got all of the lashing on us that we need already. Let's get some sticks. We got plenty of sticks up here that I have accumulated. And then we'll go get a tarp and complete our little survival kitchen. So the hobo stove is kind of an extravagance because, you know, you don't want to be cooking a lot of meat that is eventually going to go bad. But I don't know about you, but I want to cook my shark on a stove instead of a smoker. Let's see which way this is facing. See if I can, no, it doesn't look like it influence which way it's facing, so that's fine. There we go. That is our little survival in the Caribbean kitchen. All the water we're ever going to need, as well as some cooking utensils for whatever we might find. You know, the pelicans and the bats sound delicious right now. But of course, gotta keep our eye out for any sharks. So the next thing we're gonna do in this episode is we're gonna head to the north. And I think it's the northwest. To the northwest, there are two cells on the map. Let me just go ahead and put all this junk. There's two cells on the map that are considered deep. And I really would love to just kind of explore up there and see if there are any dives that are worthwhile going after, as well as maybe seeing if there's any wildlife that we can say hello to slash, you know, murder and then devour. Murder dot devour. Murdering, devouring. It's good. And then what we'll do is we'll discuss kind of what we're going to do with this gigantic platform here. Because, yeah, like you'll see in my Let's Learn for building, it's really unfortunate that you can't build further out than three cells. So, yeah. I'll stop whining about that, and let's move on over to the raft and head to the northwest. Alright, so we are on the most northern... Let me get on the sail. That thing's too loud. We're on the most northern part of the map. You can actually see the buoys going both directions here. These are the buoys going west, and then you'll eventually see the buoys going to the east over here. And I've yet to spend a lot of time in the deeper regions of the map. And what I'm hoping for is that maybe we can see some whales, or maybe see some great white sharks. You know, something other than a tiger shark would be great. Maybe we can do some dives. We'll see if we can see any bubbles in the water. Just kind of look around and enjoy the deep waters. Not seeing any dives at all. We can start heading west and maybe we can... Oop. Got ourselves a shark. Alright, let's see what it is. Oh god. I'm kind of scared. Alright, let's see if we can see one. Can't see anything in that dark water. I'm a little bit worried though. When we defeat a shark, it kind of spazzes out and falls to the bottom. I don't know if we're going to be able to claim our prize. Because I tried putting a pig on here, and this poor raft sunk like a rock. If I could somehow prop it enough so that I could, like, take all the meat, that'd be great. Oh, where's the shark? Oh, don't tell me it left. Come on, there's a juicy morsel over here. Keep on heading west, then. Come on, Sharky, Sharky. You want to see something other than a tiger shark? No! Where'd it go? That's very sad. I'm not seeing any dives over here, either. I'm going to slowly make our way west. Oop, here's the sound again. I'm going to stay on the sail so I can see. Just want to see its body. Come on. Maybe the water is just so dark you can't see anything. Might as well just hop in the water. See what we... Oh, there we go. Oh, baby. Look at that thing. That doesn't look like a tiger shark. Oh, my gosh. Oh god, I'm so scared. Oh, run! Get on! That didn't look like a tiger shark at all. Oh god. So scared. Go. Get in! Get on the boat! Got two hits on it. Wow, that thing's huge! Thing is huge, guys! Oh man, this is like the third take where nothing happened. And I'm so glad that we ran into something. Oh man. Come on, where are you? Where are you, baby? Where are you, baby? Oh, I don't see it. Oh. Game's kind of loading a bit. As if something else came out here. I just want to see its face. I want to see its pretty face. Oh, God. Ref physics. Oh, no, I think it left. I think it left. No. Oh, it's back. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Come to Papa. Oh no, it's starting to get dark. Oh! What? What happened? Oh my God. We're so screwed. We're so screwed. Alright, come on. Come on, baby. Where are you? What just happened to the raft? Oh my God. Hear it. Hear it. Oh, jeez. Oh God, I'm sorry, I'm spinning like crazy. I have no idea which direction it's gonna come from. And the raft is capsized for whatever reason. I wonder if I could use the motor like this. I wonder what would happen. I had nothing. Oh God. Oh jeez! Got another hit on it. Got two hits. I can't even get up. I don't even know how hurt we are. Just one tick. That's really surprising. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh. Let's see, right next to my sail, as if it's gonna stop a great white shark. So we have four hits on it. I have no idea how I'm gonna flip this thing over. I don't even know if I can. It's getting dark too. Oh, I hear all sorts of things. None of it good. Oh God. Oh my goodness. I think the engine is the shark. Oh my goodness. I don't know what we're gonna do. Oh, I hear something. I'm freaking out. I don't know if what I'm hearing is like the raft. Oh God. Yep, the engine. The engine scares me every time. All right, let's see if we can get this thing flipped over. Oh my God, we're so screwed. Come on. Is there any way we can flip this thing over? Just gonna have to drag it. Oh. We are... Oh my God. I think we did it. We did it. We somehow flipped it over. Okay. All right. We can't see a thing though. Oh God. The boat is doing weird things again. Oh my God. You know, I was complaining before about how I was upset that sharks did nothing to the raft. And I take it back. I take it all back. There's no way we can see anything. Yeah, like that's gonna help. Oh my God. Oh, what? Oh, it's a marlin. Wow. Let's, yeah, as soon as we turn our light off, it's like, it's over. So that's what's making the sound, is a marlin. And I wonder if that's what's, yep, it's doing something to Raph for sure. Wow, look, well, we wanted some different wildlife. I think we got it. So that that great white shark has got four spears in it. So I'm gonna just oh man, I want that marlin so bad. I just don't know how I'm gonna. Yeah, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna wait till daytime. I'm gonna sit right here and see if we can survive the marlin and great white shark attack, and then we'll reconvene once it's daytime so we can actually hunt them. All right, so I'll be back as soon as it's daylight. All right, it's 6 in the morning, I think. Very close. Yep, just past 6, and we got a marlin out here. Really want to bag that great white shark, though. Ugh. Ugh. Can't see a thing in this water. It's way too dark. It sees a fish spear on it. Oh, went right through it. Sounded like it hit something. Oh, where's that great white? Here's the marlin. Get it. Oh, I think I pissed it off. Oh god, where's the raft? Where is he? Come on, baby. I'm ready for you. My last spear. And those spears went right through it, though. Oh, God. Oh, no. Oh, God. Oh. Stabbing. I get it. I think I got it. I think I got it. I don't know if I'm holding it, though. No, I'm not holding it. Oh, God. Yeah, we're bleeding. All right, so I'm going to mark the spot. That was a great white. That was a great white. We totally just stabbed it to death. It's dead right there. Oh, God. All right, we're going to go heal up. And that buoy is where our trophy is. Pretty sure I got it. It felt like a rock. I was like inside it. All right. Oh God, that was crazy. Now the question is, can we really like dive deep enough and then somehow get it on the raft? Oh my goodness, that was awesome. I mean, first off, are we gonna get back in time to be able to survive this bite? Oh my gosh, can't believe we did it. I've never bagged a great white in this game. I've bagged hundreds and hundreds of tiger sharks, but never have I gotten a great white. Oh my god. My island is super laggy when you zone in. Come on. All right. So, we killed one. We killed it. Next episode, we will go get it, and we will savor its sweet meat in our new, we'll cook it in our new hobo stove. I mean, not all of it, but at least one big piece. All right. Oh God, don't crash into all the buckets. That'd be terrible. All right, put this away. Get this back on the shore. All right, we're obviously still bleeding. It's a good thing we are well equipped. All right, not bleed anymore. Okay, it's probably going to be a couple days until we're all healed up, but I'm going to take care of myself. I'm going to heal up, and then in the next episode, we'll go ahead and see if we can reacquire our trophy, because I'm pretty sure that thing was dead. It dropped like a rock after I hit it a couple times. But yeah, we're going to go and rest up, heal up, and then the next episode, we'll go and see if we can get that great white shark. Oh boy. All right, folks, this is Johnnyonoes playing Stranded Deep version 0.16. I'll see you guys in the next episode. Thanks so much for watching.